So Crunchyroll is coming out with a new original anime series known as X-Arm. Now you have to admit, the art right here looks really nice. Kind of gets you pumped for a trailer. I bet that animation's going to look great. Oh, right. About that. Hey, what is going on, everybody? How are you all doing today? I hope you all are having a wonderful and fantastic day today, and if not, hopefully you all will have a better tomorrow. So, Crunchyroll is coming out with a new original series known as X-Arm. While the art looks good in terms of the manga and what they're showing off here, well, when it comes to that trailer, the animation is awful. I don't know what they were thinking when they thought that releasing this was a good idea, because this art, it's so bad, and fans are downvoting this, understandably so, because this art is just that bad. So, a new teaser trailer for the upcoming Crunchyroll original TV anime X-Arm, based on the manga written by High Rock and illustrated by Shinya Komi, has been unleashed on the world, previewing the opening theme for the show Rise Again by Airflip. Think about this, this is very misleading, because when you take a look at the artwork, right, that they're trying to show off, you think, oh, the art looks great, this looks like something I could jump into and get interested in, but then you see the trailer. This trailer is so bad. I mean, like, you know, right now, currently, you have Crunchyroll, who is trying to do damage control. They are trying to save themselves from being sold off to Soini, as you can clearly tell. And then, of course, they come out with something like this. I mean, this just looks awful. This is like classic PS2 graphics, in my opinion. This is just really bad, especially for, like, the modern day. You would expect, if they're going to do a 3D anime, you would expect it to be top-notch. You would expect it to be a lot better. And to think, this is where the money's going, right? To stuff like this. Oh, it's absolutely, it's just jarring and just disappointing. Oh. And, you know, Crunchyroll has had its problems in the past, like, you know, whenever they told everyone that they were going to help pay animators in Japan, you know, help them out more, and then it turns out the money, well, where did it go? It went to Elation, and then, of course, you know, High Guardian Spies, rather than going to the animators. So, you know, Crunchyroll lied about that, which a lot of people took a lot of issue with that for good reason, because they thought their well-hard-earned money was actually going to go to supporting animators over in Japan, because they have a hard time making a living as animators. And then, of course, you know, Crunchyroll said, oh, hey, look, you know, yeah, we're going to help them out. And then they lied. The money went to Elation. And then, of course, that was also with High Guardian Spies, which still hasn't seen public viewing at all, you know. It's still basically in limbo, it seems. And then, of course, now they're at risk to being sold to Soini, which apparently final negotiations are going on right now with that. So, you know, Crunchyroll is not in a good spot, and this animation doesn't help. I question who thought this was a good idea. I really do. Oh, because that animation is just horrible. X-Arm delivers a futuristic cyberpunk series thanks to director Yoshikatsu Kimura, series composer Tommy Morton, and F-Zero-X soundtrack composer So Kimura, composing the music at 3DCG Anime Studio Visual Flight. The voices of Soma Saito, Hermes, in Is It Wrong to Try to Pick Up Girls in a Dungeon as Akira, Mikeko Komatsu, Sokka in My Teen Romantic Comedy Snafu as Minami, and Akiri Kito Kotoko in Inspector as Alma, brings the characters to life. Now, think of it is that when you look at this, I mean, this poster right here, right? Yeah, that is good art. That's something that people would enjoy. And personally, the way I see it, I like 2D anime more than I do 3D anime. Personal opinion. But I just think that it flows better. I mean, I don't know. That's just me. Now, I mean, there can be some 3D animations that can look nice. But in this case here, with what Crunchyroll has done, this does not look professional. It looks horrible. I mean, it looks like shit. I mean, it really does. And, you know, they question, well, why are we for sale? Well, this is probably why. Because you're taking the money from AT&T and Warner, and you're making bad animations like this. And yet, when they team up with Japanese studios, like, for example, Rising of the Shield Hero, if you look at that, that's a pretty good series, in my opinion. I actually enjoy that pretty well. And, you know, it shows that they can do some good stuff, that they have some good works. But then when you see trash fire animation like this, well, it doesn't really make you question why WarnerMedia and AT&T are trying to sell them off to Sony. And that's not the only thing, though, because fans slammed them hard. Because they not only hit that downvote hard on them, but man, the comments were great in their video. I'm actually surprised they haven't tried to shut off comments, because we've seen them do that before. So here were some comments. This looks like someone's first SFM animation when the Crunchyroll Originals logo looks better than the anime. Oh. When you're the only animator but have a deadline to meet. Oh. Hitting them where it hurts. Ouch. Don't forget, guys, this is where everyone's subscription money goes to. And they're right. That person's right. This is basically where it goes. I mean, this is why people were upset already with the High Guardian Spice issue. And now to see that this is going on, well, yeah, of course, people are not happy about this. Understandably so. You know, if my money was going to poor animation, I would be furious as well. Yo, this looks like cheeks. How did this trailer get approved? How did any of this get approved? Who looked at this and was like, yeah, we're good to upload? I agree to that. As a professional 3D animator, I am embarrassed for you looking at this. Oh, that's rough. This makes the worst of Ruby's animation look like a Pixar film in comparison, good lord. Oh. It is somebody who's seen every single volume of Ruby, including the worst of it. That's rough. And Ruby, it's terrible with its animation now. Oh, is that rough. Oh, guys, bad CG is being attacked by bad CG. Nothing like trying to sell people late 20th century CG there, Crunchyroll. Yeah, Crunchyroll, the 90s called, and they said they wanted their animation style back. Oh, I don't know what anybody was thinking. Like, how in the world do you let bad animation like this fly? I really don't understand this at all. You know, like, me personally, I'm more into 2D anime than I am 3D anime. That's my personal opinion. I mean, I've seen some good 3D anime, but this is an example of very terrible 3D animation. I mean, like I said, I don't understand why they thought this was a good idea. And, you know, with Crunchyroll trying to justify themselves to AT&T to try to stay relevant to them to prove that, hey, look, we can make you the money you want, you know, and then they pump out something like this, right? I mean, oh, it's so bad. And, you know, you would expect more. You really would. You would expect a lot more, but then you see stuff like this, and then it just drops the expectations. I mean, it just completely disappoints people. You know, fans get just very disappointed. And this is why they're slamming Crunchyroll, because this animation, you know, it could be so much better. I mean, it really could be. And it's like they just rushed it. It's like they were just like, oh man, another anime to get out there. Let's get that animation done. Let's pump it out there as fast as we can. And then, of course, you know, it became the mess that we see now. It became that complete trash fire. I mean, you know, and the thing is that it's a shame, because when you look at that art, you know, that they were using to kind of show it off, not the trailer itself, but just the art, it looked good. It looked clean. And then you just get that 3D animation, and man, it just takes a spiral. And of course, this is why people are downvoting it. This is why people are upset, because the subscriber money, this is where it's going. It's going to bad animation. You know, people were upset also on Twitter. I mean, you know, going on talking about this. The anime made by people who never made anime in anime before looks like exactly what an anime made by people who never made anime before made an anime before. I mean, you know, this is where it's going. This is where the money's going. You know, it's absolutely frustrating. It's disappointing. And, you know, you would think that it would be going to try to make good animation, to paying the animators over in Japan, like they said. And it's going to stuff like this. I mean, this is why people are so upset. And, you know, Who would want their money to go to mediocre stuff? You know what I mean? Like, you know, whenever you would hope it would go somewhere good, you would hope that it would be into something that's going to be good, you know? And then, of course, you see this, and it's just disappointing. Oh, shout out to Floof. That like-to-dislike ratio. Can't believe they made a dollar store iteration of Gin Freak. The dollar store iteration of the dollar store mecha shows. Oh, because Genlock flopped and Rooster Teeth. Oh, I get it. That's great. But you see, that's the thing. This is where that subscriber money is going. And to see it just be as bad as this, I mean, could have been 2D, and it probably would have been a lot better. I mean, if you look at the art for, like, the promotional poster, it looks great. But then, of course, you see the animation, and there's that. It's very misleading. And Crunchyroll, you know, they wonder why they're up for sale. Well, this is exactly why. But anyways, let me know what you think about this entire situation down below. Subscribe to this channel if you are new here, and make sure you were still subscribed, because YouTube is unsubscribing people from all their favorite channels, so make sure you were still subscribed to all your favorite channels. Hit the video with a like, and also be sure to share the video on social media. Spread the word and get it out there. It's greatly appreciated, and it really helps out the channel a lot. Also, be sure to follow me on Discord. We have a wonderful community there. Not only that, but it will keep you up to date on when the newest videos will be released, as well as any other upcoming events in the near future. So be sure to follow me on Discord. The link is in the description down below. But anyways, I hope you all have yourselves a wonderful and fantastic day today. And remember, if today was not a good day, tomorrow can always be better. Take care of yourselves and everyone around you. And have yourselves a good one out there, everybody.